So the Swiss Press photo is about 28 years old already. We have six categories. There is news. And news, we have this picture, which is a strange picture because it's some kind of a catastrophe which was in Basel. And the people are looking at this huge smoke wall, and they look at that like it is something happening, and they like it. They do selfies with it. But then in the end, it was nothing. Happily, it turned out well.
It reminds me of a very iconic picture of the 9/11, of the World Trade Center. That's a big question for a professional, which is, how do you read a picture?
Well, I always say the picture tells more about the guy who looks at it than about the guy who took it. So we project what we know into a picture. So now you project it. Mm-hmm. Thomas Höpke, 9/11, you saw this in this picture. Otherwise, in the Swiss Press photo, as we are press, that means there must be some news in it. And so this is the event is important and the good picture.
And of course, I think that the circumstances or the context also play a role. Like in the sports picture.
That's a very good example, because that was one of the biggest events of the year. This Xhaka and this Doppeladler. That was a huge discussion about. And it's even so that in the jury they said, oh, we saw this picture, we don't like it anymore because we saw it too much. But it's the picture of the year. From there, a whole discussion started. So this is a good example of a news picture.
Yeah, because there's also the thing that how you can convey a story in one image.
That's it. For example, you have the daily life picture, you know, the Saint Nicolas, which goes into a prison, and the photographers can go in. He feared a little bit to go into the prison because he thought we shouldn't show the people who are in there. It's delicate. But finally he went in and everything was okay. But he decided that the picture when they go in is the best. There's other categories. For example, there's the foreign category.
World, yeah.
It's always very strong what the material there, because the Swiss photographers like to travel, they like to go outside. So this is a camp for ISIS people who learn to get back to civility. So they try to make a psychotherapy in this camp. And the photographer, Michael Zumstein, he had the chance to go into a camp like this in Mali. The challenge is to make a good news press picture in Switzerland. You need the photographers as authors.
For me, brings me exactly to this picture we're seeing
now. That's a good example, very good. That's Nicolas Brodar. He decided to make a series of photographs of the vision of a conseiller fédéral. So this, for example, is the right hand of Perse. She's working with him, and she's looking if he's coming or not. And so this is the whole series is about that.
The series of Alain Berset, what is wonderful about it is that it really shows the authorship of the photographer. And then when you see this portrait, there is a narrative in the portrait. Is that what you look for?
If you take a portrait of somebody, there is an interaction. This is a very good example of a portrait which the people you photograph, they give you their picture. Mm. It's always a collaboration between the photographer and the one who is photographed.